Some car companies were dragged kicking and screaming into the electric vehicle market by the 10-state zero-emission vehicle ZEV mandate, hastily shoving electric motors and batteries into existing products with only the most minor changes. Volkswagen, however, seems to be warming to the presumably still unprofitable task of selling EVs, bringing out a refreshed e-Golf only 2 years after launching an 83-mile range model that nonetheless managed to sell nearly 4,000 copies in the US last year. The 2017 e-Golf's best trick is that it can now stretch 125 miles of range out of a lithium-ion battery pack that, we're told, has the same number of cells and weighs the same as before, yet rises from a rating of 24.2 kilowatt hours to 35.8. Magic. It reminds us of the horsepower screw that Wolfsburg turns to make identical engines achieve different output ratings in VW and Audi models. VW says the e-Golf's improvement was accomplished via battery optimization. The new model is indeed packing a new battery pack with revised cell chemistry, not just a software change, and there are no plans to offer owners of older e-Golfs the upgrade. Hey, they didn't upgrade that iPad of yours every time a new one came out, did they? Welcome to the incrementally improving world of e-cars. Horsepower also increases, from 115 to 134, while torque rises from 199 pounds to foot to 214, which should make the e-Golf scamper a bit harder. VW will offer the new e-Golf in three trim levels, the SE, the loaded SEL Premium, and a limited edition model that splits the difference and includes some of the SEL Premium's features. The 7.2-kilowatt onboard charger becomes standard on all three models, meaning a common level 2 240-volt charger will recharge the car in less than 6 hours. While that sounds like a long time for a refill, anyone who has lived with an EV knows it will suffice for most situations. And DC fast charging, which is an option on the SE but standard on SEL Premium and limited edition models, can do an 80% charge in an hour. A short drive along the California coast proved that the reasons to choose an e-Golf are the same as the reasons to choose any Golf: access to VW family values, including a rock-solid platform, excellent dynamics, improved, actually, with the lower center of gravity due to the battery mounting below the floor, and fastidious interior packaging. The new 3,450-pound e-Golf can indeed be a silent sprinter off the line, with plenty of thrust to keep pace with traffic. 60 miles per hour is yours in a claimed 9.6 seconds, but that's surely conservative, as we did it in 9.4 with the 2016 model. It'll go 85 miles per hour, sufficient to collect a speeding ticket pretty much anywhere in America.